Si el ritmo te lleva a mover la cabeza, ya empezamos como es. Mi música no discrimina a nadie, así que vamos a romper. Toda mi gente se mueve, mira el ritmo como los tiene. Hago música que entretiene. El mundo nos quiere, me quiere a mí. Toda mi gente se mueve, mira el ritmo como los tiene. Hago música que entretiene. Mi música los tiene fuerte bailando y se baila así.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's look is gonna be this look right here. I wanted to do something more summery for you guys. Have been asking me, what do I wear for summer? What type of look do you guys wanted to see? So here's the final look. I did more of a bronzy and a little bit more of a bronzy look and a little pop of color to it, just because bronzy, pop of color, they look good together. So I hope that you guys enjoy this look. Let me know what you guys think. All the products that I used today were products that I love personally. So, personal tips, things that I love. So, yeah, let's get started with the videos and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So the first thing that I'm starting today with is gonna be this oil. It's called MD Measurable Difference Coconut Oil. It's really good for hydration. It's also good for the body. And it has vitamin C in it, which I love. The next thing that I'm gonna use now is gonna be a moisturizer. I got this in my Ipsy bag and it's called Symphony Beauty. And then I'm going to go ahead and use my Too Faced Hangover Primer. So the first product that I'm going to show you guys that I love for this is this foundation right here. It's by Urban Decay Naked. It's very lightweight and it has an SPF in it, which is SPF 20. So I'm really sorry for the background noise. Literally my room is above like traffic. Well, not above traffic, but side traffic. So that's why you guys can hear cars passing by. So with this foundation, I do build it just because I kind of want to hide my freckles and my redness in my skin. So that's why I tend to use a little bit more than 2 or 3 pumps. The brush that I'm using is by Morphe and it's the style G36. I love Morphe brushes. I feel like they really get in your skin and it makes the foundation look a little bit more natural than some other brands, and they don't shed because a lot of my brushes that I had from Ulta or other different brands, they tend to shed a lot, and that's no bueno. I mean, but it also depends how you clean your brushes, so I'll take that back as well. So the next item that I'm going to be using is my Morphe eyebrow palette. I use this mostly on my clients, but I also use it on myself just because I want to create an arch to my brows, and I've been loving using more of powder brow stuff than the usual pencil that I used to use or gel formula. So I'm going to be using this color right here. It's more of a dark brown. You guys get the memo. And I'm going to be using my Anastasia brush to do my brows. I feel so weird doing. Doing a talk over when I'm usually doing voice over. I've been going to this girl to do my brows, and she is a god because I used to go to somebody else and they completely ruined my brow. And little by little they're growing and the arch is coming in, which I'm really excited about because sometimes I would look crazy. I was looking like a straight chola, just saying. I do like more of a strong brow just because I like more of an arch, and because I want my brows to be more the definition of the look. Strong brows. Mm-hmm. So now that I'm done with my brows and priming my eyes, today I really wanted to just focus and do more of like a summer look. To some of you that are like, okay, I need to go out to a party and I need to look finesse, but I also don't want to like overdo too much. So yeah, so next I'm going to be focusing on my eyes. We're gonna focus in our eyes. So I wanted to do more of like a bronzy look.
Okay, let's do this.
So this palette, it's by Lancome. It was in one of their gifts from last year that I got for buying the gift because I love shopping. This is the palette. This is how it looks. And it's called Color Design Palette Blush Settle Delicate Oil Free Powder Blush Destination Sunshine. Blah 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 blah. Here we go. Who keeps texting me? Okay, so the next thing that I'm going to be doing is going into my palette and using the color right here. This color right here, they don't have names, so it's like a really bronzy color. And I'm going to focus that in my lid with my Morphe R37. Sorry, this faded. Actually, let me take that back. I'm going to be using this brush right here. It's more of a flat brush, so I can get it in my lid. And then I'm gonna go back to my blending brush. So basically what the look for today is, I don't want to do something to overwhelm you guys, but I'm just doing something that will scream like summer, more of a bronzy tones today. You know, you feel me? So I'm gonna go back and use this color right here and put it in my lid. Ooh, that's beautiful. Bam. And go back to the first color I'm really focused that all over my lip. I'm literally just going to be using two colors. And I'm gonna go back again with the second color. So my eyelids will pop out a little bit more. So basically I'm using now this brush by MAC, and it's in the style MAC brush 221. And I'm just using it just to blend all the colors together. I usually do this look more when I'm in a rush, and let's say we're going to beach or we're going to a barbecue or just anything going on laid back, just so it's not so what's the word that I'm looking for? It's not like I'm doing too much. It's a glam, more of a glam look, and it's more subtle. And I'm gonna go back again and use my fingers just to pop a bronzy shadow. So next we're gonna go back and use our Tarte Shape concealer. I usually do more of a B just because I want this area to be more bright. But that's like my own personal thing that I do for myself. And because I want to highlight certain areas in my face. So the next time that I'm going to be using, I look freaking crazy, I know. It's my MAC. The Fix Plus and my Morphe brush in E48. This brush, you could use it as foundation or bronzer, but I chose to use it as concealer brush just because I really want to get in there. So the next thing that I'm going to be using is my Laura Mercier loose setting powder for underneath my eyes, just to set them. And I'm going to be using this brush. It's by Real Techniques. I got this a long time ago, and I usually use this a lot for my under eye, just to really get in there and set everything. Going to be using is my Smashbox, I don't know if I'm saying it right because my accent kicks in and horrible, photo filter powder foundation. I use this one because I am mucho oily certain places in my face, and it helps me out throughout the day. So the next thing that I'm going to be using, I don't know how to say this word. This is like horrible of me. It's by NARS. It's actually a collection that came out a few months ago, and I remember my friend was telling me about it. She works on NARS, and she was telling me that this was coming out. It's one of their bronzers. It's so pretty. I don't know if you guys can see it. It's called Felices. I'm not sure if I'm saying it right, and I'm really sorry if I'm not saying it the correct way. But next I'm going to be using the Morphe M. I'm going to be using the Morphe brush in the style M556, and this is for bronzer. So next I'm going to be using this bronzer by All Over Glow Bronzing Powder. It looks like this. It's so pretty. Just to give you like a nice tan summer look. It has like little sparkles. And it gives you more of a dewy finish. So the next thing that we're going to do is use our Laura Mercier. Our Laura Giller Gilded Honey Highlighter. This highlighter is everything, and yeah, I literally use it all the time, as you guys could tell. So I'm going to be using this brush. I got this brush last year, and it's by Tarte. It doesn't really have a style of it, it's just a fan brush. And I'm going to just use it for highlighter. Place a little bit of highlight my nose. Voila. Okay, so the next thing that I'm going to do now is go back to the Lancome palette that I was using, and I'm really just going to focus on putting the first color, which was this one, just to place it underneath my lash line, just to give it some pop color before I put any lashes on or do my mascara. And I'm going to be using my Morphe brush in the style M41. Looks like this. And I'm going to grab that color, tap it a little bit, and put it underneath my lash line. And after I'm done with that, I'm going to be putting my lashes on. The lashes that I'm going to be using today, again, I love these lashes for so many reasons. I just feel like my makeup looks natural So sometimes I don't want to go all crazy with the lashes. I usually do more crazy if I'm going out or if my makeup is really dramatic. And or I think my makeup, okay, rephrase that again. I love these lashes for so many reasons, because it goes good with anything. Even when if you don't want to put eyeshadow on for the day, you just want something to pop your eyes and make it look like you're awake, I usually use the Ardell lashes in the style Demi Wispies. I am obsessed with these lashes, and usually when I don't want to look crazy and I have to go out to run errands, I usually put these on with mascara, a little bit of BB cream, mascara, lipstick, and good to go. So next I'm going to be using my Estee Lauder mascara in the name Sumptuous Extreme. I love this mascara, and I was speaking about it in my last video because it gives you volume and lem, and it really separates your lashes really well. I feel like with other mascaras, well, some mascaras, it makes your lashes look a little clumpy and all like mixed together, and I hate that. So this is what I like using this one. And I'm also gonna do this. Put it under the bottom lashes as well. I always do this, I always get mascara in my freaking nose every time. It never fails. So next I'm going to go back to my highlighter by Laura Geller, and I'm going to use that just to give it a pop to my inner corners and to make me look more awake. This brush is by Sephora. I don't know what style is it, but I love using it for my inner corners. All the time, all the time. And most of the stuff that I'm showing today, guys, it's things that I love to use during the summer. So next I'm going to be using my Estee Lauder Double Wear Stay in Place Lip Pencil in the color Coral. I love using their pencils, and I used to use them when I used to work for them. If you guys didn't know that, I used to work for Estee Lauder for 2 years. And I used to be really upset with their lip liners, because they would like stay on and they would be matte, so like I wouldn't even have to apply lipstick after the matte. So like, that's freaking awesome. So next I'm going to be using the Anastasia Lip Lipsticks. I don't know what color to use. I have here either Spicy or Permission. I think I'm going to be doing spicy.
I don't know.
Yes.
It could be like this, look.
There goes my neighbor.
Yeah, this is a-
Well, guys, I'll see you guys in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, subscribe, and tell me what you guys want to see next. Thank you so much for all the love and support. So, yeah, I hope that you guys have an amazing weekend. Bye.
Si el ritmo te lleva a mover la cabeza, ya empezamos como es. Mi música no discrimina a nadie, así que vamos a romper. Toda mi gente se mueve, mira el ritmo como los tiene. Hago música que entretiene, el mundo nos quiere, me quiere a mí. Toda mi gente se mueve, mira el ritmo como los tiene. Hago música que entretiene, mi música los tiene fuerte bailando y se baila así.
La fiesta no para, apenas comienza. C'est comme ci, c'est comme ça. Ma chérie, la 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 la. Francia, Colombia, me gusta.
Freeze.
Y Balvin, Willy William, me gusta.
Freeze.
Los DJ no mienten, le gusta mi gente y eso se